Hey guys, I wanted to take a quick moment to talk about the new Angels and Airwaves EP. I had heard about Tom working on some acoustic arrangements of some of the first album that he did with Angels and Airwaves, and it kind of snuck up on me. I didn't realize that the songs had just come out yesterday or whatever. And you know, I'm digging it. You know, it's definitely cool to revisit those songs. You know, he's done so much since he's left Blink and then went back to Blink and left again and whatever, but you know, that was one of those albums where I just kind of forgot about how much I love those songs. And it's definitely cool to see him in a different way, because he doesn't necessarily just follow the same structure and the same exact formula that he did for those original songs when they came out. He definitely added a lot of different elements to it, which I definitely appreciate. I think his voice sounds good. I mean, it's not like it's the way it did back in 1999 or whatever, but, you know, who expects that to be that way anymore anyway? But, you know, somebody will complain about his voice. But, you know, I thought his voice and his vocals were very appropriate for the music, you know. I like how he did a lot of softer parts. And he did some stronger parts, you know. He definitely changed up a lot of the guitar lines. He changed up some melodies just to kind of rework them and try to envision them in different ways. You know, I definitely do appreciate that, like I said, and it kind of presents them in a new way, and I think it's cool. You know, a lot of bands out there will put out acoustic versions of albums and it's literally just the same exact album but on an acoustic guitar, and it's I don't know, half the time it just ends up disappointing me and doesn't really give me anything cool to listen to, anything new. It's just like, all right, well, there's the regular version, there's the acoustic version, which is exactly the same except with acoustic guitars. They don't really retranslate it to make it fit an acoustic setting that well, and I really do think Tom did a good job with it. I do hope that he continues doing more. I heard that he was teasing some other songs that he was doing, so it would be cool to see the rest of the album. I think the rest of the album has some really strong tracks on it too. I really like A Little's Enough. The Gift is a great song. Start the Machine is a great song. I do think while Good Day is kind of not really one of the stronger songs, I think it would lend itself really nicely to an acoustic environment, so that could be really cool. So that being said, you know, it's a cool little EP. I don't think it's a negative thing at all. I don't think he really wasted his time. You know, some people are saying, you know, why are you bothering with something like this when you could be working on new music? But you know, I see where he's coming from. You know, sometimes you want to revisit that magic that you had, you know, 10, 11 years ago, and just kind of play around with it a little bit. And I don't think his effort was wasted. You know, I think they did a good job, and I think that it's worth checking out. You know, if you're a Tom fan or Angels and Airwaves fan, you haven't checked it out yet, definitely do. The whole album is on their YouTube page right now, or the whole EP, sorry. So definitely give it a listen. It's pretty neat. And that's pretty much all I got to say. I mean, how much can you really say about the album that, you know, I haven't said already? I do have an album review of the full album on my page from like a year or two ago, if you really want to hear my full thoughts on this album, on the regular album. So let me know what you think. I definitely am curious how your opinions compare or contrast to mine. So definitely let me know. Thanks for watching. Catch you guys later.